Hello everyone, it's been a little while since I've videoed due to circumstances focused on, you know, staying present like I'm sure all of you have been, and I just want to wish you all and you and yours that you're happy, healthy, safe, and connected. I'm supposed to be in Hawaii right now, but luckily I'm in a beautiful space here in San Diego, California, and I'm safe and grounded and supported, so I couldn't be more happy about that. So I've been videoed for a bit, just kind of getting my bearings and getting everything in order for me so then I can be connected and share with you all. But I've had a lot of insights around our relationship with food. I wonder how yours, some of your insights have been. I know the spectrum, I'm very familiar with it because I have been on this spectrum, you know, like controlling all my food, to emotionally eating, which we're going to talk about, and just like letting go. I want us to just be okay with whatever, with what is. One good thing I think that's going to come out of this is the diet mentality is going to maybe end. Let's just end focusing on keto, paleo, being perfect, this, that, macronutrients. Not the time or space. It's great to have some structure, but the main structure is knowing what works for you. So, for example, I bought these potatoes under stress the first round because I had a lot of trouble at the grocery store because I went late and there was a lot of, like, not much left. So I got this whole bag of potatoes. I've been passing them out. I made them a couple times. And then last week, my body didn't want potatoes. But a part of me was shitting on myself to, oh, but I need to eat them. I need to eat them. I'm like, no, you know better. There'll be a time and a place. So that's what I want for you all, is to just know these little teeny, or sense these little teeny sensations, actually, that your body says yes or no to. A lot of you might know this one, eggs. Yesterday morning, my body, I was yes on eggs. I was out all week because we were having egg shortage here, and I got eggs, and I made eggs yesterday. Today, I woke up certain that I was probably gonna want eggs again, and it was a no. So how much do you trust that, all right? That would be where we want to grow from, not the macronutrient keto paleo blah 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 program. It's this, you're the program, and now is the best time ever. One of my beautiful friends, Jennifer Welch, a couple years ago totally blew my mind. I probably was having some guilt around emotionally eating, and I was like, oh, I'm emotionally eating right now. She goes, why don't we just call it eating? And in that moment, I just went, oh. So all the work that I've been doing with my relationship with food even broke freer. And that's why I was playing with feelings, and that's why we have the food relationship type quiz. Because when we get deeper with that relationship and that knowing, we're freer, everyone. So that's what I want for you all, not to be shitting on yourself that whatever you're eating or not choosing or choosing is wrong. That's not where we need to be at all. I actually just took a picture of my can of lentil soup, which is like security for me, okay? Whatever it is for you, this is security. When I lived on the boat, I had a case of these. So I felt secure. And if I ever wanted them, or if I didn't have food, or I was in between grocery shopping, I have this. Then I also got vegetarian lasagna last night, which was the same thing. Security. What if comfort and security can merge a little bit? What if we like let go of some judgment? I know that with this new situation we're all in, my relationship with food is upgraded even more. Like I'm like, whew, you know, this feels right. This doesn't feel right. And then again, doing the best you can with the resources we have. So I was very limited because I was in a vacation rental. So I had to start from scratch. But I cooked for my friend and I, and I had a couple batches of things when I came over here. So whatever you can do to help feel secure, comforted, supported, and you're knowing. That is the secret ingredient, right? So it's just learning your knowing. So if you're not eating wheat, or you're not eating dairy, or you're not eating this, you're not eating that, cool. But be careful with that too, because there could be some judgment when that's maybe what your body wants, or what you have at the moment, or someone gives you. So that's what I would play with. All right, so I'm making my artichoke soup for your soul. So instead of chicken soup for your soul, it's artichoke soup for your soul. Where did this recipe come about? Oh, one of my favorite grocery stores. I had like got a little bowl of it one day, and I was like, what? How did I not That's not what I usually go to. I'm like, how did I not think of this? So I couldn't wait to put in my recipe book for you all. And my recipe book is not about following perfect recipes. If you all have watched any of my videos, I'm like the furthest from perfection as you can possibly get. It's a baseline to give you comfort, ideas, connection, this knowing that I'm talking about. That's what this recipe book is. That's why I have you tune into your body first before just following this recipe or I should eat this. So in the recipe book, I don't have potatoes in it, but I'm sharing this with my friend and I was like, I'm ready to put potatoes in it. Plus I wanted something a little heartier. I was kind of eating light for a couple days and today I was like, oh, I'm hungrier for something heartier. So those are heartier too. Our heart needs support. Those are the little cues to listen for, all right? So I have 6 potatoes in here. I cut them up already, so you don't have to see me cut them up. Can you see that? Yeah. And then carrots and celery, which my friend gave me, by the way, because the store was out when I went one time, but now our stores are getting better. So we're getting more supplies here. And then I also didn't have broth, so she gave me chicken stock. So if you're a vegetarian, go ahead and do veggie broth, but I didn't have it. So do the best you can. I'm excited to try it though with the chicken stock. So potatoes, I did some broth. Oh, I sauteed the potatoes for a few minutes with some coconut oil first. Started to stick right away. So I was like, oh shoot, I had it on low heat too. But again, I'm always at a new stove a lot often. So here's the artichokes. I usually get halves, but I didn't get the halves because I was probably rushed and a little under pressure. Aren't we so fascinating how awkward we all are at the store and how mindful we're trying to be, but we're still awkward. Yeah, it's a whole new process, right? And I keep hearing everybody saying getting back to normal. Wow. I mean, we want everyone to be safe. That's the normal, but we're going to be all different people after this. I really do believe that. Systems will probably change. Maybe some systems we didn't even prefer might be changing. All right. So, otherwise quartered would be better. I didn't feel like cutting them. It'll cook up too. And so they'll kind of break up a little bit. I didn't feel like cutting them. Do what you feel, you guys, do what we feel. And then I'm gonna put a little more chicken stock in here. So she made broccoli cheese soup, I think. I can't remember. Oh no, I think it's a vegan broccoli soup. So we're doing a trade. I was at her house up the beach here before I came here. So we're not infected at all because I was already living there before I came here. And then I'm gonna do oregano. I'm a little low on seasoning. So next time I go to the store, I'm gonna grab more seasonings. So I'm gonna do oregano, and then I got this like mixed salt because I didn't have anything when I got here, so I just grabbed this one. So yeah, I'll let that simmer probably for, I'll probably like fork the potatoes and the carrots. But this soup, holy moly, when I did my retreat, we served it for breakfast actually one day with avocado toast. Oh, so good. Great as a side dish. Sometimes soup is boring and we want something more. So it could just be like you're preparing dinner and you're preparing something else, but you're really hungry. Have a cup of something like this. This is wonderful for you. Very hydrating, tons of minerals in there, which all of us are needing because stress is just pulling minerals out of our body in milliseconds, I can tell. So the more we replenish, the better. With your leftover remnants of vegetables or whatever you're doing, keep some of those and freeze them. And then I'm just gonna make my own stock when I start to stock up, pun intended. All right, stay tuned. I am gonna offer a group support program later this month, pending, taking it day by day. It's all we can all do. And it's all about nourishment. It's not about restriction or follow this, don't follow that. It's about, again, learning these cues because I can't tell you how even more liberated I am these last few weeks with learning more of these cues. And like my beautiful friend Jennifer Welch saying, what if we don't call it emotional eating? We just call it eating. So watch your guilt, like on a scale of 1 to 10, if you're eating from a level 10 and it's blank, that's not, no matter what it is, it's not good, okay? I don't wanna call it not good. It's not supportive for you. That's the work, everyone. That's where we get to work. And letting go of comfort, should, shouldn't, black, white. I think we're all seeing that. The black and white is pretty gray. So find your own inner knowing. And I'm here to help you with that. And I'll put a link for my recipe book for you. It's more like meal ideas. And again, it's about a baseline. And I want you to build what you need from that. All right, see you later.